So we're back at it again today. Today we're going to be working on upper body strength. So I think we're going to start off with flat dumbbell bench, and then we're going to move upstairs because that's the only place where we can do chin-ups on a chin-up bar. I will do that as our primary lifts, and then row or a fly. It's kind of accessory stuff. So we'll see how it goes. He just had a skate yesterday, so and he has another one today, so yeah, we rather work on upper body than lower. Okay. Did you want to play music or?
Sure. Hold on. Let me rearrange the order. My knees are killing. They're really? Sore as a bum.
Play. Just hit the first one.
Sure.
Like, 3 hours from the reserve feels like you're kind of feeling the burn, and then you let off. This one, it's like, you're going hard,
and then it's like, that one that you, like, you really need to push for, like, last rep, it's like, just don't be done. You know what I mean? So, different, maybe a little bit different mindset.
So, let's go. You ready? Well, you see me do this one, but another good mobility drill for shoulder is like a teacup where I do this. So I need to hear that crack. So doing that, you can do that way, and then you can also do it on the forward for each arm. Nice. And the idea is to, yeah, keep this as straight as possible. And it's just the arm moving. And 2.5, I didn't start out with that. I started out with like something that like felt like nothing, but yeah, that's it. And the idea is you keep your hand flat the entire time. They call it, from what I know, they call it teacup because you don't want to break it. Like, you wouldn't want to drop a teacup, right?
Yeah.
And so you keep it flat, and so it forces your shoulders to have that range. So sorry, the idea with this 4 week program is that like having the same exercises the same way, it allows us to track your progress. So if we're doing chin-ups one day and then we do dumbbell bench to replace that, to, like not in addition to it, but to replace it, and then we do barbell, you know what I mean? So it changes it. So after a block or two or whatever, we can go and change the exercise just for the sake of a different stimulus, but for the sake of tracking progress for those, for these 4 weeks, at least let's keep it the same. Okay, here we go. Core backs to the bench. There you go. That's it. Do however many is gonna make you feel good, but don't overdo it. So if that's 12, that's 12. That's 15, it's 15. That's it.
push. Don't bounce. Don't bounce. Stop.
You're leaving soon, right? Like in an hour?
Yeah, we didn't start this till like 11, 30, 40. How many did you do with the 30s?
10.
You did 10
or 11?
That's pretty solid. You think you could go up or no?
3, 4, 5.
I mean, that's all we have. Or we could do bench press. I wouldn't like to mix it, but because that's a 15-pound jump per hand,
I can. Yeah, I'll go up. I'll probably do like 5 reps maybe.
You think we can use the 45s, yeah? Alright, let's do it. You want a little more extra, you're good.
I'm good.
Yeah, it's weird, but you just gotta kind of fall back.
Yeah.
Then yeah, use your legs, so. That's it. You got it.
Ready?
Up. There you go. You got it. Up. I know the first part, it's hard to get it up initially. Like, way harder it usually feels when it's heavy. And then usually I've always been good after that. Take a second. So how I usually do it is I usually, actually bring it back, and then I think I let it, like, control but fall out, right? Because I think before I used to try and push like this, straight out, and it's like a lot of tricep. But when it's out, when you let it fall out and you go like this, like, it just, I found it was easier. Yeah, so I'll help you with the first one and just go. Don't hesitate to try and like see if you can do it on your own, because I'll just help you with the first one.
Okay.
You're good, man. You got it. Fall back and then let your knees and thighs kind of kick it up a little bit. Yeah? Alright. So on the count of three. Ready? Yeah? So, 1, 2, 3. There you go. Again?
Yeah.
You got it ready? I go like this, and then I think I hold it like this, and let one drop.
Okay.
And then I twist, and then at that point I can twist my body and use the whole thing down.
Yeah.
So that was good though. That was good. And you don't have to, when you're down, you don't have to bring to the middle to connect them, because what happens when the weight gets heavy, and this bothers kind of my shoulders, is that because when we go up like this, like, we push with our chest, and we gradually get over our shoulder joint, right?
Yeah.
So it's stable. The second we bring them in, and now the weight's here, and our shoulder joint's here,
yeah,
that causes, like, unnecessary strain for our shoulder to stabilize and keep it there, right? You know what I mean? Like, to exaggerate it, what if I asked you to take the 45 and try and hold it like here? Like you can just like looking at it and picturing it, you'd already be like, damn, like that would hurt a lot. You know what I mean? Like that would feel like unnecessary. So yeah, when you push, just keep it over the shoulder joint. Because it's a different too. What do you wanna?
Well, what would you wanna start with?
Bent?
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
I don't want you doing more than 8. I don't want you getting more than 8. You think you can get more than 8 with 45? Haven't done in a while, huh?
Yeah, like, I've done bench. Nothing told me to, but like, I've only like 4 sets, 3 sets, or 4 reps, 3 reps.
Really?
Yeah, that's what I wanted to do.
Who?
The throw game.
Oh. That's the problem with it. I don't think you should be doing that just yet.
Yeah. Put it back on. I like it.
You like it?
Yeah.
You can't feel it. Why? Can I hurt you?
Mm-hmm. Just comfy.
You shouldn't be resting on your chest, though.
It won't be resting. It'll just be like tapping.
Okay. Nice. There you go. Just tap. Push. Push, 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 push. There you go. Yeah, how you feel?
Yeah.
When is that, like 6?
Yeah.
Let's do that again. And going forward, we should maybe try and time a little bit more if we're doing things like bench 4 or 5 sets. Mm-hmm. And then doing chin-ups or pull-ups. That's because they both take a lot out of you, right?
Yeah.
So, trying to make sure it's spaced out and then, you know, you're able to recover. Are you doing a lift off or no? Okay. Nice. Nice push. Got it, you got it. Push, 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 push. Nice. So I'll go first and just think you're using here just to get you up. That's it. It's not, don't think of it as like a reach, don't anything else other than just that was 9. I had to pause a little bit just so I wasn't sweat. I didn't start to sweat.
Yeah.
But yeah.
And then you can tuck this leg over like that if you want. Nice. Breathe away up.
Alright, that's alright. How many is that? 3 or 4?
5.
up, up. There you go. Stop there. Stop there. Okay.
So same thing as last time, right? So bent over as far as we can while being able to perform the movement. So arms going straight back like wings, hence them being flies. Mm-hmm. Right? And again, look down. I'll be checking your form. So no need to try and look at yourself. That, and then as soon as that, I again don't know what this is called, but like alternating arm and leg raise, I guess. Bird dog. So.